What is the roundest thing in the universe? Yep.
No, just saying.
Oh, no, no. Oh, not at all.
You should see it. No. The roundest thing in the universe.
Yeah.
Ball bearings.
Ball bearings are quite round, but
they're swallowed a ball bearing.
The roundest. Give it smoothest, most round.
Well, the most purely round, in other words. Because if you. Well,
the Earth is a thingy, is it squashed? It's not round.
Not round. No, that's right, it's an oblate spheroid.
Oh, Nelly Furtado!
He's got a word for everything.
Is it a liquid drop, a water drop?
They can get jolly round. They can be very round. Very nice. We're actually further out of space than Earth, beyond Earth. It's a cosmic phenomenon.
Is it a black hole?
It's that kind of a deal.
Oh, it's those space helmets, those big round helmets with the things on the top.
Is it the thing called the genius point? Is it the point to which everything goes to, ultimately?
Not that. It's when a supernova has a gravitational collapse, it turns into something called a neutron star.
No.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, the neutron star.
Yeah. They're really round.
That's not round!
No, that's not. That's a supernova, I think. That's a supernova. Going supernova.
Then show us the round thing!
He's very upset, aren't you?
Yes!
It only has a diameter of about 15 miles or so, and there isn't one near enough for you to be able to see it with the naked eye.
Have you ever noticed how we always have to take Stephen's word for it?
But what's interesting is that if I had a thimbleful of a neutron star, it would weigh more than a mountain.
Yeah, but you don't.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll tell you what, imagine how confused the old woman darning your socks would be if you had a thimble full of it. She was just trying to fix a hole and there's all space and time coming out of a thimble. That's no way to treat the elderly.
You're right.
So you put a thimble down and no one could pick it up.
No one, no one at all.
And when you've got a good cleaning lady, you want to hang on to them. You don't want to mess it around. I'm leaving, Mr. D. Why? Well, because of all this space business with your thimbles. I don't like it.
It might have double the mass of the sun, but it's only 15 miles across, roughly. And the highest mountain on it weighs 5 millimetres. So it is superbly round.
Because
as opposed to the Earth, which, although the Earth is jolly round, apart from the flat bits at the top, the point about the Earth is it's actually jolly smooth compared to, say, a billiard ball.
Smoother than a ping-pong ball, isn't it?
Yes, now, why is that a snooker ball...
I'm sorry, I did not know there would be a follow-up question.
Yeah.
why is the Earth...
If you were to scale up a snooker ball to the size of the Earth, the mountains and trenches would be hugely greater than our highest mountains or deepest trenches, i.e. the little pits that you can see when you examine a snooker ball closely, if scaled up to the size of the Earth, would be gigantic. So the Earth, in that sense, is smoother than a billiard ball.